चंद्रकांत नाट जाएंगे, अय्यप्पा नाइट जाएंगे। हाय गुड मॉर्निंग नाजनीन।
हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
यस फ्रेंड्स, गुड मॉर्निंग टू यू ऑल। हाउ आर यू ऑल?
वी आर ऑल क्लाउड नाइन सर।
वाओ, दैट्स रियली ग्रेट। वी आर ऑल ऑन क्लाउड नाइन। वंडरफुल। In fact, I have sent the message to all the people to be in the group, at least.
There still our
but I am very
our
happy.
Group still, yeah. Our group members all are not joined.
Not joined, but you people have come in time. I am happy about it, at least. Good. Let us wait another 2 minutes. Is there? So, what is the agenda today, Nazneen? What is your plan? Are you going to sing or dance?
Dance, dance. Nazneen will dance now.
She didn't tell anything,
sir.
Okay.
What she will do? So.
Yeah. How did you plan, Nikita ji? What are the activities? What is your schedule?
Yeah, I just gave the welcome speech. Then I will call upon Mr. Raju for some sharing some jokes. Then I would sing one song. After that, I will call Mr. Sakti Babu for one joke, to share some funny jokes. Then call Jivita to tell something. She is telling something about a story or your experience in Royal Campus.
Okay.
Both of them he can tell. Then after that, I will call Chandrakant. Yeah, he will give a poetry. He will present a poetry. And then now it Venkatraman ji will share the experience of Royal Campus.
Very good.
Royal Softfield Campus. Then Sudha ji will sing a Tamil song.
Sudha Ramakrishnan. Wow, very good. Very good.
Yeah. And lastly, Rajuji again from
joke.
Raju sir will.
Venkatramana sir is also capable of singing. I got to know that. But you are not.
But he is already actually sir singing, na?
Separate. Sir, you have kept separately.
Share the experience.
Yeah. No, experience so will be shared different. By all the people. Anyhow, as soon as the certificate is displayed. Now I will tell my agenda. So when I am giving the certificates, I'll be sharing a few positive things about each candidate, and your certificate will be displayed. Then I'll be asking about your feelings about Royal Softskills Campus journey.
I am the first person.
Yeah.
Everyone will.
Yeah, everyone has to share that way. So this is the agenda from my side. So let us
you can go. Tell once again the experience.
Yeah. So we are very happy that things are happening, and this, as I told you, know, this is just the beginning. I mean, or else, how to say, this is only end of one cycle, and this is the beginning of our association forever. In fact, in this particular 25-day agenda, whatever topics to be discussed that we discussed. And what are all the syllabus, whatever syllabus is to be covered, that we covered. But now you are all in the right direction. Now you have got the ability to speak correctly. You have got the ability to express your ideas confidently. Now what is the right expression? What are the wrong expressions? All these particular things now you are aware of. So our chief guest, Mr. Sampath Pantangi, has just joined us. Again, I think some signal. Sampath sir is there. So, Mr. Sampath Pantangi, good morning, and you are most welcome, sir. And I welcome Nanduri Subbarao from Gudivada, I believe.
Thank
and
you.
He is a journalist and is a writer. And he is also one of our guests today. Fine. Are you getting my voice, my dear friends? Are you comfortable?
Yes. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
So today we are going to start our session in another few seconds. Still, one of the keynote speakers, one of the guests, Saujanya Bhaskara, is yet to come. We are waiting for her. Anil Sushil comes, the proceedings will get started. So let me very quickly give you the agenda today. So first will be prayer. First aspect will be the prayer. And after that, welcome address and opening address will be given by me. That will be for about 10 minutes. And then Mr. Sampath, he will be giving an address in the capacity of the chief guest. And then keynote speech will be given by Bhaskara Saujanya. Then Mr. Venkat Ramana, a noted Vedic maths person. He has many feathers in his cap. Today he is going to show off his talent as a singer also. Then after that, a guest lecture. Mr. Karthik will be our guest today. And he will be giving a guest lecture. And he is a multi-talented person. He has got this neuro-linguistic programming skill. And apart from that, he is a psychologist and he is a hypnotist. And then after that, the real agenda, the real event for which we have all gathered today, that is your valedictory session certificates will be distributed. And during the certificates, each participant will be given an opportunity to share his or her ideas about the success journey that he or she has had with our Royal Soft Skills Campus Paperless Fluency Blueprint Workshop. Then after that, cultural programs. So for about 30 minutes, the cultural programs will be there. And the people who can sing, they are going to sing. I do not know. It is the people kept it secret. So 30 minutes time you give to us, we will do whatever we want. Fine. I am also eager to see your cultural activities. Fine. Then, of course, finally, we are going ahead with Vande Mataram. And then we will be dispersing. So this is the agenda. Now, Saujanya Bhaskara has also joined. I welcome Saujanya Bhaskara and Mr. Sampath Pantangi. So now I request Sudha Ramakrishnan Madam to start the prayer song.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Can you unmute yourself, Sudha Ramakrishnan?
Good morning, all.
Good morning.
Yeah, my salutation to everybody. Shri Vignarajam Bhaje. Shri Vignarajam Bhaje. Shri Vignarajam Bhaje. भजेहं भजे तमिह श्रीविघ्नराजं भजे श्रीविघ्नराजं भजे भजेहं भजेहं भजे तमिह श्रीविघ्नराजं भजे सन्ततमकं कुञ्जरमुखं शङ्करसुदं शङ्करिसुदं तमिह श्रीविघ्नराजं भजे सन्ततमकं दन्तिसुन्दरमुखं मन्तकान्तकसुदं शिवशङ्करिसुदं तमिह श्रीविघ्नराजं भजे सन्ततमघं दन्तिसुन्दरमुखं मन्तकान्तकसुदं शिवशङ्करिसुदं तमिह श्रीविघ्नराजं भजे श्रीविघ्नराजं भजे भजेहं 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 भजे तमिह श्रीविघ्नराजं भजे सेवित सुरेन्द्र महनीय गुणशीलम् जप तप समाधि सुख वरद अनुकूलम् सेवित सुरेन्द्र महनीय गुणशीलम् जप तप समाधि सुख वरद अनुकूलम् भावित सुर मुनि गण भक्त परिपालम् भावित सुर मुनि गण भक्त परिपालम् भयंकर विशंक मादंक कुलकालम श्री विघ्नराजं भजे श्री विघ्नराजं भजे भजेगं भजे दमिक श्री विघ्नराजं भजे श्री विघ्नराजं भजे. Thank you all. Thanks.
Very good. Very good. It's a nice way of starting the day. A very traditional, very auspicious way. Really, we never knew that Sudha Ramakrishnan, also known as Kamakshi Madam, she could sing this nicely. We do know that she is a person of multi talents, and today she has proved herself. Really great, Madam. Excellent rendering of the Ganesha Pratana. Excellent. Very good. So Jivita, I need to thank her that she invited her friend Shweta Reddy also. Really, my sincere thanks. Shweta Reddy has also joined. That's a good sign. So now, coming to today's session, let me quickly introduce our chief guest and our guests and all these particular participants over here. So my dear friends, today our chief guest is Mr. Sampath Pantangi, and he has been working for TCS. So now let me show you. So I welcome to this valedictory function to all the participants, chief guest, keynote speaker, and the guest lecture. Sampath Pantangi is our chief guest. He completed his master's in engineering from IIT Madras. He has been working in TCS for the last 21 years. And he is a project management professional, certified, and currently is performing delivery partner role for a large US customer. He is also actively associated in GOIT Corporate Social Responsibility Initiative. His other interests are reading books, watching cricket, and listening to music. So I warmly welcome our chief guest, Sampath Pantangi. I request all the participants to give a big round of warm welcome applause to our chief guest.
Thank you very much for your warm welcome.
Thank you, Sampath. And here is our keynote speaker, Saujanya Bhaskara. And we are very happy that she is going to share her valuable experiences with us. And she is into motivation and inspiring the people. Are you getting the claps sound, my dear friends? I made that some experiment yesterday. Claps noise, are you not?
Yeah, yes.
Oh, great, great. Thank you. So now coming to Saujanya Bhaskara. She's a passionate software professional. She is also working for TCS, Tata Consultancy Service. She has a 17 years experience in TCS. She holds the responsibility to win and execute multi-million US software projects. She manages delivery of key strategic projects. Her additional responsibilities include creating agility in the teams, voice for diversity and inclusion, and creating innovative mindsets in her unit of size, 1,300 plus people across geographies, various countries, her team members are working. So in addition to all these things, because always a woman is great, I always say that. The reason is that she has multi roles to play, multi roles she has to play. She is a homemaker, and at the same time, she is even working as a software professional. In fact, this is a rare feat one has to also. And this her speech is going to inspire you in this angle also, because most of the people, they feel that, oh my God, how can I take up a dual responsibility? She has been doing this not for one day or 2 days, for the past 17 years, successfully she has been taking care of these responsibilities. She is the mother of two. And she has so many family responsibilities, like, you know, our Indian conventional traditional families. She is taking care of her in-laws' family responsibilities and her mother's side responsibilities also. And so many responsibilities she is taking care of. And at the same time, Her hard work and her innovative work style is recognized by the organization, and she has been getting continuous elevations. So because about a woman, we need to understand her achievements in this kind of diversified angles. We need to observe. That's the reason I am talking at this length. So welcome to Saujanya Bhaskara. All of us, let us give her a warm welcome.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much. You richly deserve it. And our our guest lecturer is Mr. Karthik. He made a request that he'll be joining us by 7:45. In fact, he is an international certified life coach. He is an NLP trainer and he is a certified hypnotist. He is an inspirational speaker. And I'm proud to have friends like this, Karthik, Sampath, Tantangi, and Bhaskara Saujanya. And Karthik will be joining us by 7:45. Yes, now I hand over the session to our chief guest, Mr. Sampath Pantangi, and he would like to share his feelings, and he is going to inspire you all. Over to Mr. Sampath.
Thank you. Are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir. You are very, very much audible. Okay.
Thank you very much. Firstly, I would like to thank Dr. Vivekanand for giving me this opportunity. And it's my pleasure to be part of this event today. So thinking about this subject, I thought I will probably talk a little bit about the importance of communication and why it has to be rightly done. Communication is definitely not just talking. It is understanding the context, putting it in the right spirit, and then having the clarity of thought, then giving it out with the right expression. So all this put together would be called as a communication. And whatever aspects are there beyond talking, will come under soft skills. So Dr. Vivekanand has written a book on soft skills, which I went through. He has captured all the details in detail with the right examples on how important they are and why a person should possess them, so that it will make the conversations will be meaningful. So I thought I will take three examples today and explain the importance of soft skills and the importance of right communication. Some of my hobbies are watching cricket, reading books. So my first example goes to the epics. Okay, most of you might have heard about Ramayan, and all of you might be aware that Hanuma will go to Lanka, visit Sita, and take care of certain things there, shows his talent and then his strength to Ravana and his team intentionally, and comes back to Rama. Once he comes back, then Sugriva and others will ask him, so what did you do there? So there Valmiki explains his heroics for close to 300 poems. He will tell them his strength and how he created fear in people of Lanka, and how he showed his strength to Ravana and tried to convince him and everything. Okay, then Rama comes to the stage and he will ask Hanuma, so what did you see there? Immediately, everything will change. Situation will change so dramatically. Within three poems, he explains that he visited Sita, and Sita is very in great grief. She is desperately looking to meet Rama. Within three stanzas, he will cover. While covering that, all of you might know that monkeys by nature will raise their eyebrows, give all these funny expressions and all. But he clearly depicts that no change in expression, little bit of sorrow in voice, and all eyebrows did not rise at all. They're at the right position, and the posture is appropriate and like that. So that explains if you are a person with wisdom, you should understand the context and explain or put your thoughts in the right context and appropriately communicate. That is the first example. My second example goes to my passion to cricket. So I'm sure like most of you might be following cricket, but predominantly in cricket, what I love is the commentary and the analysis post the match. So in one of the discussions, Sachin explains this. Okay, so he himself and the team went to Sri Lanka once, and all of you know that Lasith Malinga is a very unique player. And in the very first match, they were not able to understand what he is trying to do, whether he is trying to bowl in swinger or out swinger or yorker, how to really face the balls. And they got out for, say, like around 150 or 180 runs. Then they had a team discussion. Then Dravid and Sachin came to a conclusion. So most of you know that if it is an out swinger, the seam position will be away from the wicket. And if it is an in swinger, the seam position will be towards the wicket. And a bowler will have an advantage of 3 seconds or 2 seconds as against the batsman to observe the hand position of the bowler and see how he is going to bowl. So they said, whoever is at the non-striker end, they will give a gesture with the bat. So say, like, if you have a bat like this, right? If it is away from the wicket, that means it is going to be an out swinger. If it is towards the wicket, it means that it is going to be an in swinger. And if it is straight, the non-striker end batsman did not really observe what the bowler is trying to do, and then it's very difficult. So it is up to batsman to figure out what the bowler is trying to do. And with that common understanding and the clarity of thought in communication, they were able to bat better in subsequent matches and were able to play Lasith Malinga well. And this talks about the things beyond verbal communication that will really come into the play when you are into a situation. The last one I talk is about the corporate, right? So for the last 12 years, I have been into the campus recruitments, and my role would be predominantly to do the management evaluation. Most of you might be aware, there will be two to three rounds in the evaluation. First one will talk about the technical. The second one will talk about the managerial. So as part of the managerial, our responsibility is to observe the candidate, how committed he is, and how good he is in communicating, and how is his clarity of thought and expression, right? So there are so many instances which are observed during the interviews. First thing people talk, all of you know, right? When they are coming for interview to TCS, they cannot say, I'm really passionate about either Cognizant or Capgemini or Infosys, but I just came for the interview because I got selected in the written test. They say that I love TCS and I want to work only for TCS, nothing beyond that. The moment you ask the next question, what is TCS annual revenue for last year, there wouldn't be any answer. Or even if you ask the question like, who is CEO of TCS, no answer. So you should have the complete information about a subject as much as possible before you really get into the discussion for the subject. Okay. The second aspect is, putting it in the right words and ensuring communicating properly. So interview will typically stand for 15 minutes. The first 5 to 6 minutes will predominantly help the managerial interviewer to make up his mind about the associate. So off late we started asking, because mostly people will be rigid and they will not open up. So we ask about what is the movie you have seen recently, and can you explain it in, say, 2 to 3 minutes? So that 3 minutes is given for the associate to come up with the points that he wants to communicate about, either the match he has seen recently or the movie he has seen recently, put in the right context, and then message it correctly so that his clarity of thought is observed. Some people will say, they say that, okay, I did not see any movie recently. Then that ends the conversation. Mm-hmm. There is no conversation there. Some people will say, I don't like watching either English movies or Hindi movies because I'm a Telugu guy and I love watching Telugu movies only. So such kind of expressions will really stop to move forward with the conversation. Okay. So these are the soft aspects of the communication. So to put all these expressions summarize, and if I have to say like 3 to 4 sentences for you, one thing is communication is not just talking; it is beyond the talking. That includes your posture, then understanding the situation, then communicating your thoughts. First thing is sequencing your thoughts, communicating your thoughts with the right words within the given time frame, then ensuring that you will close it on an appropriate note. So all this make up the right communication, and all these are very well explained in the soft skills book, and you can probably go through that. And now that you have a base, you went through the training session, and all of you know it's a continuous learning process. So please do not stop here. Continue enhancing your skill set. Continue reading books, talking to the people. Be collaborated between your batches and then the batches who completed the course before you. Then have either group discussions or chat or things like that, so that between you will be able to create a forum to have continuous improvement in your either soft skills or communication skills or English, spoken English, etc. With that, I'll conclude, and I wish all of you a very best with your future engagements and endeavors. And I would like to thank Mr. Vivekanand one more time for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Mr. Sampath Pantangi. We are very much delighted. So in fact, the precise talk which you have given, it is filled with gems, valuable diamonds, kind of pieces of information. So they are invaluable. So usually we use these kind of words, invaluable, precision. But today I realized the meaning of these words. So in a precise way, very precious words you have given. And in fact, all these particular 25 days, whatever I have taught them or trained them, you summarized in a crisp manner, and once again, you made them to reaffirm themselves towards the journey and towards their goal. Thank you very much, sir. And I am really got motivated. Whenever you get time, in fact, today I firmly made up my mind to travel you, to invite you as a guest lecturer also. If you have some free time, it will be the pleasure of my students. Thank you.
Thank you.
Now, I would like to invite Saujanya Bhaskara to give her keynote address. And Saujanya Bhaskara, as you know, that she too is working for TCS. So especially this, you might have observed one thing about Mr. Sampath and about Saujanya. They have got long service record, track record with one organization, which is glaringly missing in present generation youth. So in fact, in present generation youth, they believe in harping from one organization to another, job hoppers, they say. So that is a trend which has been glaringly observed in the present youth. But there is one thing, consistency always will give you great amount of results. So this is one particular message that we can carry. You see, it is unspoken message they are giving. They haven't spoken about it, but we need to get that particular unspoken message also. Because being in the company of great people, it gives us inspiration in many ways. So that's the reason always you believe in the fact that 5+1 principle. You develop 5 people of your goal-related people. So the kind of person you want to be. So similar kind of people, you develop friendship, 5 people in your contact list, and try to get in touch with them. At least, if not in person, you will at least go through their videos, go through their speeches, go through their books, or articles, or whatever. Then ultimately, you are going to be the 6th person. So 5+1. So this is one principle. So what kind of people you need to get in touch? Today you are getting some better idea. Now, without taking much time, now I hand over the stage to Saujanya Bhaskara. Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Sampath, sir. It's really humiliating for me to be here now. yeah, but I'll try my best. Since sir gave a lot of speech about me, I'll try to live by those words for the next 15 minutes. Okay. So a warm welcome to you all and good morning to you all. I hope all of you are in Indian time zone. It's morning for you all. In the previous meeting, there was people from different time zones. That's why I'm in shortages. Sir, you, all of them are in the same time zone, right? So everyone, it's morning?
Akhila is there from US.
Oh, okay. So I did touch her then already. Yeah. Good evening, Akhila.
Good evening.
Okay, so now I will just take a couple of minutes, or rather initial 4 to 5 minutes to talk about my journey. Sir spoke about my 17 years of my career, so I am interested to speak about my career now. So my journey from a developer to a delivery manager of 17 glorious years in TPS. How did it happen? Without any break. And I never had to step out of my working role, which means I was never on bench, as you call it. So I was continuously, except for my maternity leaves, I was really not taking any major offs from my work schedule. So how is it possible raising two teenagers? I mean, currently my kids are teenage group. So raising two kids, taking care of the family, and also living to this point. A little bit go back to my childhood days. I'm eldest of three kids at home. And from there, well, I always assumed I'm the leader of the house. So I always believed leadership is not given, it is assumed and the kids executed from your hands. So being the eldest at home, I always assumed that position myself. And I had a very happy childhood. Both my parents were academicians, and they always encouraged me in taking up everything, be it debate competitions, be it quiz competitions, or extracurricular activities like singing. And also, I am a classical dancer. I'm a trained classical dancer from my childhood. And I keep performing now and then, even though I'm of this age. This last year, I performed in Ravindra Bharati. So I keep, I try to balance all of these aspects of my personal passions and my family values, and also my work responsibilities. I also call my career as my passion. Without passion, you just cannot do a lot of these things so long. If you are just asked to do something, you may do it for 2 years, 3 years, but you give up and want to run behind your passion. Unless something is a passion, you just cannot continue to do something of what you are doing for so long. So yeah. So I also from as a child, I always wanted to become a doctor. My entire family dreamt me to be a doctor, but I narrowly missed my medicine seat. So my entire family was went through a lot of grief on that particular day. It's just not my family, my extended family. Everyone's dreams were shattered, because we were like a very good combined family. My aunts, my uncles, everyone, my grandparents. So everyone in the family really felt very sad at that moment. But then I made a U-turn. I have given an exam and completed my graduation in computers, because that was not picking up during early 1990s, like that. So I have picked up computers and then finished my graduation and also post-graduation. I really took it up personally and struggled to make sure that I wanted to prove again, I'm the best. I wanted to prove that to my family that I'm still the best. So I have secured a 7th rank in my master's entrance examination and 1st in the women's category. So that's where I have decided that whatever I thought did not happen, but whatever I am getting into, I want to make my best. So finally, I have finished my master's, but again, there was a challenge. There were no campus interviews for our course, there was CAMCET used for Master of Computer Applications, but there was no CAMCET used for Masters of Computer Science for my course. So even though I have studied in Ho Chi Minh Women's College, the campus was taking my colleagues, but not me. Then again, myself and my family support, I made up my mind that I have to join a good MNC, not settle with any smaller companies. I'm not telling it is bad, but it was my choice or my decision my dream to be part of an MNC. So that's where I was given time from my family to prove myself. So I took that time and given a couple of interviews, and finally I have made it to TCS. And from then on, I have a lot of reasons for not leaving TCS. At the same time, I just get a lot of opportunities as well to do in TCS. So we were there at on-site for 3 years and then came back. And then I'm still playing very good roles at offshore. And now also in a very rare occasions or when the project is struggling, at least once in 2 years or so, if I'm required, I'm traveling. I'm not telling I'm not ready for travel, but long term, I'm not ready for travel. That's the stance I made with my company. And company is respecting that. So because I told my choices, I was never deprived of getting any promotions. And I am also so proud to stay in front of you that I'm on par or neck to neck with my male colleagues in achieving any promotions for this experience range, despite two maternity leaves and whatnot. So it's all about your passion, your commitment, and your resilience that takes you long. So that's what I was trying to present from my story. Just give me a pause. I need to talk to my family. Just give me a pause. I'm sorry. Okay. I hope I'm audible well.
Yes, yes. Yeah, while looking at some disturbance was there, now it is very clear.
Okay. Thank you.
Now your voice is clear. A while ago, I think some noise reduction as well as a disturbance was there. That's great. Thank you. You are really. Thank you.
Okay, thanks. Sorry, I missed to tell one point. The gap was there, right? Like when I finished my post graduation and when I was looking for a job. So that's where Mr. Vivekanand sir gave me good tips about how to crack interviews. And even I have my aunt also who has been working in LIC, so she also gave me good tips. So at that time, at that time, these institutes were not so popular and the communication institutes were not so institutionalized. But now we have good institutions, especially Vivekanand sir has really come up with a good module which will help us crack all of these, and he has written books about this, he has written articles about this. So it is so organized and modularized today, so we can really capitalize on all of these investments upon us. So you all have made a right choice, and you all have got into best hands, I would say, to shape up yourselves. So now you are all ready to, I'm sure you all have been already in your professions, achieved a lot, and now you are all the way more prepared to face your professional challenges, I would say. So my key messages to you today, besides my life story, my key messages to you today would be about, so you know how to speak, right? In last 25 days, you have understood how to speak. But this is where the difference of knowledge and wisdom. So any guesses anyone wants to make the difference between knowledge and wisdom?
Yeah, Raju sir. Raju,
knowledge is the information that we acquire. Wisdom, the application of the knowledge.
Yes, sir. Perfect.
That is hello, madam. More or less, you are right, sir. That is a skill and knowledge. That is the difference between skill and knowledge. Wisdom, you are very nearer. Your answer, second part of your answer is very nearer. Further, you can find your answer.
Yeah, I'll make it very simple. Yeah. Knowledge is, you know that content and how to speak. And wisdom, I have redefined, sir, with your permission.
Yeah, yeah.
I have redefined. Yeah. So wisdom is when to speak and when not to speak.
Discretion, using our discretion.
So it's see, communication is not only about talking, and communication is also about you should know when to keep quiet. That means in a conversation or if a dialogue, it's between two persons, the dialogue is happening. So you should know when to empathize, when to react, and when to keep calm, and when to be getting into the listening mode, when to be getting into the talking mode. So you should know that switch in your mind. So wisdom is, I'm just making it simple, when to speak and when not to speak. So this actually I learned with my, of course, every learning comes with the failure, but that's why we say fail fast and learn fast. But when you learn, you keep that learning. Don't repeat that same mistake. So one of my bosses in 2005 in US, he told me, Sojanya, open mouth catches more flies. I mean, that's just that one sentence I can never forget. So whenever I'm really talking more, I realized that, okay, it's time to switch off. It's time to stay back. So you are not expected to talk here. You are expected to listen. Of course, sir called me to talk today, so I'm extemporally talking. But yeah, so that is the first lesson. Okay, it's clear, right? When to speak and when not to speak. So now you know how to speak, what to speak. But the additional lesson I'm giving you is when to speak and when not to speak. That is the understanding you need to have in any context you are in. And the next point I'm going towards is your thoughts is what you deliver. What you think is what you deliver. For example, I again had this instance with my colleague recently. So that's why I'm bringing up this point. For example, you have a client. You know him personally, you know him from your neighborhood. You may be thinking about him, he's a fat guy, ugly guy, and a hell-pecked guy, and whatnot. You have such an image about him. When you have such an image about him and he's your client, when he comes in front of you, so how are you going to talk to him with a clear mind? How are you going to use the right words to him? Definitely you will not be making the best of your communication if your thoughts are not clear or not right. If you have a wrong impression or wrong thoughts in your mind, you cannot communicate right. That is where I am coming to the point that watch your words, watch your thoughts, watch your actions. This is what we call in our Vedic, that it's Trikarana Shuddhi. That means thoughts, words, and deeds should be inclined, should be aligned. Then only you will be perceived what you are trying to tell. If you tell something and if you do something, that's it. You cannot make up that image about you. That image won't stand long about you. So a simple thing, don't think about any negative thing about other persons. You be clear, you be positive with your approach. Leave that rest of the thing to the opposite people. So at that point in time, you can really choose right words. You can really be yourself in communicating your messages. If you have any questions, please ask me if it's complicated.
So very good, very good. Okay. Madam, you made it clear that we need to receive every situation and every person without any preconditioning of the mind. Very good thought, Lavishya. Yes, audience, if you have any questions, since he is permitting you to share your thoughts, you are most welcome. It's a rare liberty you usually get to talk to such great people.
Yeah, and I'm trying to come up with my last point, the concluding point K is a constant. Usually, if you're science graduate, you know, you always define K as constant, right? Even if you are a software professional, you always define some constants in your code, variables and constants. So the constant here I'm trying to talk about is your effort. The effort should be constant. Constantly, daily, continuously, you need to put effort towards something, then definitely you will have the output in a profound manner. Exponentially, you will get an output. Vivekananda, sir, you would like to do that exercise of 1 par 01? Do we have time? I'm not sure.
Yes, fine. So, fine. Thank you very much for this opportunity. So all of you are good at algebra.
Yeah, this is my last exercise.
Yeah, we have got scholars among us, especially mathematics scholars, I can say. Celebrities are here, Vedic Maths celebrity and online digital coaching into maths and Vedic Maths. So that kind of people are there. Among, in front of them, if I talk about maths, it will be an adventure, but still, I believe in adventures. So 1 to the power of 2 square, 3 square, this kind of things, you know, right? So now with the, with the permission of our keynote speaker, I am taking this adventure. 1 to the power of 365, how much? 1 to the power of 365. Yes, sir. Where the celebrity with maths?
One only.
Very good. So now 0.99, it means what? Hardly 0.01 less than 1. 0.99. To the power of 365. Have you ever thought of how much it could be?
Sir, it will come to less than 1.
How much? There is some glaring figures are going to come today. I will show you. 0.99 to the power of 365. Kindly make a note of it. It is going to be 0.02, my dear friends. It's going to be 0.02 only. Right? Now, I will be asking the third question, the last one. 1.01, hardly 0.01 only you are adding extra effort. 1.01 to the power of 365. It is going to be 37 point, I'm doing live calculation, not a pre-recorded one. So 37.78. So it means what? What can we understand through this? So this is what our keynote speaker wanted us to observe. Yes, Venkatramana sir, please.
Sir, we have with your example, I have understood that if we improve day by day 0.01%, we can achieve anything.
Perfect. Means success, there is no rocket science for success. There is no need to do any kind of hard work. My mother used to say in Panni language, Konda Kattal Tavalsina Panni Ledu. Konda Kattal means Konda means mountain. You need not go to a mountain, you need not bring tons and tons of wood to be successful. So that much of hardship you need not undertake. Just sit in front of your books and do study. That's it. This, during my childhood, my mother used to say, to make all your dreams come true, just to focus one point extra, one word extra per day. So consistency, regularity, and small increment to your efforts, if you keep on doing, it is going to give you 37.78. 1.01 to the power of 365, it signifies the 365 days in a year. That's the significance of it. So 37.78 is the output. And if you reduce, this is one more thing we need to observe. If you reduce your efforts, even by 0.01%, you are going to have great amount of loss in your achievement. You are going to achieve 0.02 only. Where is 37.78 and where is 0.02? And if you are going to continue routine work every day for 365 days, you will be staying there only. So wherever you are going to be there only. So the key takeaway from this particular example is that increment of work, increment of effort, small addition. So doing routine in your corporate language, they call it as a stagnation. Stagnation is equal to death. So doing same thing every day will not yield results. Doing same thing plus at least 0.8 will mange more. One Pepsi ad used to come. Sachin Tendulkar used to say that. So you need to have that. Yeah, will mange more. At least every day you need to do something extra. So thank you, madam, for giving me this opportunity. So if you give mic, I will speak hours together. You took a big risk. I cannot get it.
Okay. So thank you very much. Thank you, participants, for participating in this. So now you understand what is the continuous effort and how to really grow yourself exponentially or make yourself better versions of yourself day by day. So just by 0.01, you are making better versions of yourself day by day and year on year. So by the time you're I'm hoping everyone is happy.
And your own addition is also there, madam. I remember.
Yeah.
You are kind enough.
That is there, but yeah, I will give you an e-paper.
365, with your permission, let me tell. She's a kind-hearted, a mother, you know. She's a mother. So 365 days don't work better. Saturday and Sunday, you take rest. So 365 minus 100, roughly 50 Saturdays, 50 Sundays.
54.
You take away.
54, sir.
Yeah, 54. Fine. So 265. Roughly 365. So 265 only you do. Extra work you do only on 265 days. Saturdays and Sundays you take rest. So that is the kind of addition, relaxation she gave. You see, always mothers are kind and they get extra output in the overall corporate environment. Yes, madam. Sorry, I took your input again.
No, sir. It's our input. When we share, it becomes our input.
Thank you.
So the point is, when you do that, you can do that math. So it becomes 10%. So we are not greedy. So yeah, just do this. Like just all work days, get an incremental input. Keep on giving that incremental input, and then you will get better version of 10% of your better version. So if you are in 20s or 30s, just imagine you will be like 200%, 300% better individual by the time you are in your 50s. That is your peak of your career. So with this, I really wish you all the very best. You keep continuing your whatever you have learned. You keep practicing them and you keep applying them. Okay? All the very best.
Thank you. Thank you very much, madam. Bye. Really, it's a mind-blowing. That's called standing ovation you got. I haven't instructed the people to clap. They started clapping on their own. It's a true yardstick of your, how to say, the kind of impression that you have had on the audience. Thank you. So again, I formed up my mind. As and when I get time, it is not my getting time from my side. As and when you are free, I am going to travel you people regularly. So
yes,
I want you people to give guest lectures also, not only coming on the farewell party. So this is second occasion I traveled Saujanya Bhaskara, and we are privileged to have Vishwa Sampath for the first time because he is a very busy person. So despite that, today he made it a point to come. And I'm very happy to inform you that Mr. Karthik has just joined. Welcome, Mr. Karthik. Let us all give him a very big round of applause.
Thank you,
Karthik. Really, I'm privileged to have you among us today. You have got minute by minute busy schedule and busy schedule. Despite that, you made it a point to be among us. It is so kind of you. Let me share a few words about Mr. Karthik. So, audience is Mr. Karthik is at the one corner of the country. It means he is in the Kanyakumari of our country, Tamil Nadu. But he has got global presence. You see, where you are, that is not important. What you are doing and where you are putting your impression on the world, that is important. And I am very, very happy to say that I have such a great friend. Karthik is our guest lecturer today. So today, in fact, let me share a few words about Karthik. First, let us welcome him warmly, all of us.
Thank you. Thank you.
There are so many things to say about him. In fact, let me, with his permission, let me share only a few points here and there, because so much information to share about him. That is the kind of vast achievements he has. Karthik is a certified life coach, leadership and executive coach, and a certified master practitioner and master trainer of NLP, Neuro-Linguistic Programming of Mind. He is also a certified master trainer of hypnosis. So let us pray to God. He should not hypnotize us today with his voice. So we will get carried away. That is the kind of power he has. And he holds the master's degree in software engineering. He is also the founder of NLP Academy India, and he conducts open NLP practitioner workshops and NLP based workshops in all parts of the country. In this list, you find that Hyderabad is not there. Now, very shortly, I am going to join hands with Mr. Karthik and we are going to start workshops in Hyderabad. So Pune, Indore, Delhi, Chennai, Coimbatore, Bangalore, and across the world, various countries, we conducted workshops. and he is one of the master trainers at NLP Coaching Academy in Bengaluru. He specializes, oh my God. Current wind. అంటే వాళ్ళే కండక్ట్ చేసుకుంటారు, ఆర్గనైజ్ చేసుకుంటారు.